It's 5:45. Back on my local canal. Gonna give it one more stab on here, I think. Then it's back to roach and feeder fishing and that. We'll just have to see what happens. I can't jump. Got it about 5 o'clock. 4:45. Still pitch black. I heard a cat jump right in front of where I'm fishing, so that's why I set up here anyway. I'll have to start getting up so early because I'm really tired. But anyway, that's fishing. When I'm fishing, forget the bug. I just have to get up and get fishing. I get all giddy. Anyway, I'll let you know how I get on. I just thought I'd tell you a little bit about this canal. It's a Sankey canal at Newton. Now, I've been fishing this canal since I was about 6, 7. Little rod. Light line, size 18 up. Catching little perch. Gudgeon down there. To the right, there used to be a little sandbank. Used to get plenty of gudgeon over there. I don't know whether they're still in there. I've had loads of fish out of here over the years. Big bream, tench, some big roach, eyed, perch, pike, carp. Had loads and loads of carp, loads of wilders. Never had nothing new, so I think 17, 18 was the biggest. But I've heard of bigger ones, 20s. Whether they're still in here or not, I couldn't tell you. Now, Sankey Canal was the first canal ever true cut in the land, a man-made canal ever made. They were used to widen rivers, but the Sankey Brook at the back of me here wasn't feasible to widen, apparently. So they decided to make a man-made canal. So this is a piece of history, this canal. Sorry about my throat, I've been well. I've had a terrible sore throat. Anyway, when I was a kid, you couldn't wander the whole length of the canals, but then they filled most of it in. Newton anglers saved bits of it. They dredged it, drained it, dredged it, cleaned it up. It was heavily polluted. And there's only little bits left. There's some bits at Par, near St Helens, Newton, some stretches in Warrington, Sankey Bridges, and some stretches up near Runcorn and Widnes. They never should have filled it in, but what's done's done. And I just thought I'd let you know a little bit of history about this canal and why I love fishing it so much. So I love it down here in the Sankey Valley. Even when I worked in school, the kids asked me, the kids I used to read with, they asked me to write them a story, so I invented a character called Frogbit. Anyway, it used to be on sale. I don't know whether it still is. They cancelled my contract. This long story. I could open it again, I suppose. I think there's still a few copies on Amazon. It's called The Adventures of Frogbit by Philip Brown. It's all based in the Sankey Valley and down this canal stretch here. I'll show you in a minute. It's still dark. I go for a walk every morning from the woods over there. And walks along this path to just down the bottom there. And then goes back again, and he meets all kinds of friends. Colin the Meerkat, the Pike, Sammy the Squirrel, Benny the Badger. Oh, there's many, many other, and it goes on loads of adventures. He even goes to a theme park, which I don't mention in the book, is actually Gulliver's World. Well, it's not sold many copies, about 150, 60 copies altogether of the two books they released. Anyway, just thought I'd let you know a little bit about the history of the place. And I love fishing down here. I don't fish here as much as I used to, but I still like coming down here now and again, even if it's just for a walk. God, my throat's killing me. I'm going to sign off for a bit. I just thought I'd add a bit of extra information. I think, if I remember, it's around 1750, 40, 55, 56. 1755, I think, at the start of construction of this canal. I'm not sure how long it took, probably years and years. said they didn't have proper digging tools, did they, back then? It was all done with shovels and picks and pickaxes. I just thought I'd add a bit of extra information to it. You could always Google it if you want more information. I've Googled it in the past, but my brain doesn't hold much information. Not for long, anyway. I forget everything. My light buzzes, carp all come at once. I just had a double hook up. Luckily someone called Chris was down fishing. And he gave me a hand, take some pictures and that. Well, hopefully I'll get another one or two before it's time to go home. I've only got a couple of hours now.